Dear students, so as we have discussed previous video that index point, index of a point A with respect to closed curve. So based on that, we have another important theorem which is very important, for 12 marks as well as for the 4 marks also they may give. Okay, this is Cauchy's integral formula. That is, suppose C is a simple closed contour, positively oriented. Let Z not be a point inside C and let f of Z be analytic inside and on C. Then we have to prove that 1 by 2 pi I integral C f of Z by Z minus Z naught dz is equal to f of Z naught. Now for this we'll take a circle. This is nothing but a C and there is nothing but inside another circle is there. I may take it as this as some C1. Okay, and the radius is nothing but R. R is the radius. Now this is what we have to do. So first we'll take it as we'll write capital F of Z is equal to F of Z by Z minus Z naught. Okay, since F of Z is analytic inside and on C. Capital F of Z is analytic inside on C, otherwise you can take it is analytic in the region D. So this one will make use of the principle of deformation path. You know principle of deformation path, we can able to find out C1 with the help of the C2. That is integral C1 f of z dz is equal to integral over C1 f of z dz. So same formula we are going to apply. So by the principle of deformation path, by the principle of deformation path, we can write integral C f of z by, I'll write capital F of z dz is equal to integral C1 capital F of z dz. Okay, so we can make use of F of z value, that is integral C f of z by z minus z naught dz is equal to integral C1 f of z by z minus z naught into dz. You take it as number 1 here. Okay, now this is what we got. Now what we'll do is we'll try to find out the circle, that is the closed curve C1 in the form of like this. We'll take that one in the form of like this. Okay, what is that now? Let us take C1. Now we'll try to take the value as C1. C1 is nothing but equal to mod z minus z naught is nothing but equal to r. So that implies z is equal to z naught plus r e power I theta, where theta belongs to 0 comma 2 pi. So I may write this as dz is equal to r I e power I theta d theta. Now dz value. Now I will find out the value. C1 dz by z minus z naught. So that is equal to C1. So I am going to write this as 0 to 2 pi dz r I e power I theta d theta by z is nothing but z naught plus r equal z naught gets cancelled, get r e power I theta will get. So r gets cancelled, e power gets cancelled, will be getting as integral 0 to 2 pi I d theta. That may be equal to I into theta 0 to 2 pi, you will be getting as 2 pi I. The value of integral C1 dz by z minus theta is z minus z naught dz is nothing but 2 pi I. So you got like this. Now from equation 1, we will try to take the equation 1 in the form of like this. So we will try to find out the value of equation 1. So what is that equation 1? Okay, from equation 1, from here, from that, so we will take integral C f of z by z minus z naught dz is equal to integral C1 f of z by z minus z naught dz. Now, okay, so what I will do is integral C f of z by z minus z naught minus, I will take integral C1 f of z naught by z minus z naught dz on both sides. I'm just subtracting this one on both sides. So that is c1 f of z by z minus z naught minus integral c1 f of z naught by z minus z naught dz. I'm just subtracting this one on both sides. Now if you subtract on both sides, what you are going to have? So what is this now? This is what you got. Now this I am taking as integral c f of z by z minus z naught minus, and I write this f of z naught outside, f of z naught integral c1 1 by z minus z naught dz. Then now here integral c1 is anyhow both common, so I am right, f of z minus f of z naught by z minus z naught dz. Z minus z naught is nothing but LCM. F of z minus f of z naught. Okay, so here this is what. Now what is this c1 1 by z minus z naught dz? Here you got as 2 pi. Dz by z minus z naught is nothing but 2 pi. So in the place of this, I may write 2 pi I. So what I'll do is, next step, I'll take this one, integral c f of z by z minus z naught minus 2 pi I into f of z naught, that is nothing but equal to integral c1 f of z minus f of z naught by z minus z naught into dz. Okay, this is how we got. So what I'll do is, I'll just multiply 1 by 2 pi on both sides. So I'll multiply 1 by 2 pi I on both sides. So I'll be getting as f of z by z minus z naught minus f of z naught. So I have multiplied this one on both sides. So if I multiply this 1 by 2 pi, this 1 by 2 pi will get cancelled. You'll be getting in the form of like this. So this is 1 by 2 pi I integral c1 f of z minus f of z naught by z minus z naught dz. I'll take mod. So I'll take mod 2 pi I integral c f of z by z minus z naught minus f of z naught is equal to mod 1 by 2 pi I integral c1 f of z minus f of z naught by z minus z naught dz. Now this I'll just keep it as, otherwise I'll take less than or equal to. Before that we should find out the value of f of z minus f of z minus z naught and integral c1 dz. Now what are those values? So let epsilon greater than 0 be given, and f of z is nothing but analytic inside and on C. Okay, f of z is analytic inside on C. Okay, and f of z is continuous. It is continuous on C. Okay, continuous, I can write it continuous at z naught. It is analytic inside and on C, and it is nothing but continuous at z naught. So therefore for epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta greater than such that mod z minus z naught is less than some delta, is delta, that implies f of z minus f of z naught is less than some epsilon, according to the definition, continuity definition. F of z minus f of z naught is less than epsilon, So, so this is what we have. So choose r, which is less than delta. The r, the radius of c1, less than delta. Then on C1, on C1, you may write as f of z minus f of z0 is less than some epsilon. Is less than some epsilon. Now using this one in this, I may take already we have taken 1, so we'll take this as 2. If you have taken 1, we can take that. So using this one, using these all, this is 3, using this one in 2. So what will you get now? Using 3 in 2, we get. So first we will try to find out the value of this. This is 1 by 2 pi I integral over C f of z by z minus z naught minus f of z naught, which is less than or equal to, I am just taking mod inside. So this is 1 by 2 pi I. So if you take mod, this will be 1 by 2 pi. Mod I is 1. Integral C mod f of z minus f of z naught by mod z minus z naught and mod dz. This is what we got. So therefore what is the value of, which is less than or equal to 1 by 2 pi into this is epsilon. This is something like epsilon. This is epsilon and this is nothing but delta. This is nothing but less than delta. So integral C1 epsilon by delta mod dz. This is less than 1 by 2 pi into epsilon by delta. Delta is, again you can say, r is less than delta. So I may write this as r instead of taking delta, because r is less than delta. So I may take r. R means mod z naught, z minus z naught is less than delta. Is actually it is less than delta, but if you take it is nothing but r is less than delta, I have taken as r. So this is integral C1 mod dz. This is 1 by 2 pi into epsilon by r. This is again length of C1 is nothing but 2 pi r. So I may take it as 2 pi r. Okay, now what is that 2 pi r means? 2 pi gets cancelled, r gets cancelled, which is nothing but less than some epsilon. So what you got here is mod 1 by 2 pi I integral over C f of z by z minus z naught minus f of z naught is less than some epsilon, which is less than some epsilon. Therefore I may write this as 1 by 2 pi I integral C f of z by z minus z naught is nothing but equal to f of z naught. Now this is what we got. Okay, this is what, or you can write this in another manner also, that is integral C f of z by z minus z naught is equal to 2 pi I into f of z naught. This also you can write. This is also called Cauchy's integral formula. This also called as a Cauchy's integral formula. So this is how we can solve the Cauchy's integral formula. Based on this Cauchy's integral formula, we have many problems, and we can solve by using the formula f of z by z minus z naught, 1 by 2 pi I integral C f of z by z minus z naught f of z naught. So what is the first thing you have to remember? See, once again, the how to do this problem, once again I'll explain. You take the two circles, that is nothing but C, the other one is nothing but C1, and this is nothing but radius r. By principle of deformation path, you can make use of that result, like integral C f of z dz is nothing but equal to integral C1 f of z dz. This is if you take capital. Okay, now you have to take the value of capital F of z in the form of like f of z by z minus z naught dz integral C1 f of z by z minus z naught and dz. Okay, this is one side you have taken, and you have to find out the value of integral C1 dz by z minus z naught is equal to some 2 pi I. Now this, for this you will be getting as 2 pi I. And the one more thing that you have to subtract on both sides, like integral C1 f of z naught z minus z naught dz, integral C1 f of z by z minus z naught minus dz minus integral C1 f of z naught by z minus z naught dz. Okay, then you have to take the integration and you have to apply this form here, and you have to write that f of z is nothing but analytic and it is continuous. So you have to use the continuity formula, then you have to apply in that, you will get the Cauchy's integral formula very easily. Now this is how we can do the Cauchy's integral formula theorem. Thank you.